I think what makes me unique is that I am myself. I'm always myself. Hi, my name is Linda Ifeoma Ejiofor, and I'm the second child out of five, first girl. I went to University of Port Harcourt where I studied sociology, and this is me. The second year into shooting for Tinsel, then I realized that I'm actually having fun doing this and I would love to go into acting full time. And then I told my dad, and my dad was okay with it. So
I do something, what do you want?
Do what in there? Let me see.
I would never get tired of saying this story. You see, what happened was I had finished school, University of Port Harcourt, and I had come out from school and I was modeling part-time, making the little cash I could for myself so that I don't get to ask my parents for money. Sometimes I do. So my friend Pamela, bless her heart, told me about this audition for an Mnet show. And I was like, okay, is it for a job, modeling, what? She said, no, acting. I'm like, no. Because I remembered what my father told me 5 years ago. I was studying theater arts in UI, and my dad came back from his travels and told me, come out, you're not going to become an actress. I didn't send you to school to become an actress. So I came out, and by then I was having fun. I was enjoying myself. I was like, oh, this is a life. And I came out and I changed my mindset, and I said I wanted to work in an advertising agency and I wanted to work in a company, have my own desk and all. But you see, you have one thing planned, God has another thing planned. So 5 years later, I went for the audition, and my friend told me, you know, you just have to do it. You know, it's just something you do on the side while you're waiting for NYC. And guess what? You make money while you're at it. As an Igbo girl, I say, money. I'm not like that, don't mind me. So yeah, but just being independent. So I decided to go into acting, and 8 years down the line, I've not turned back. Yeah. And my dad is a proud man, a proud father. He's like, that's my daughter. And I'll be grinning and smiling. I'll be like, yeah, I'm his daughter. It was the third year into Tinsel, and I was already getting frustrated that because people could only identify me as Bimpe Adekoya on Tinsel, the dumb blonde. And I wanted people to see me differently, see me as an actor, see me as someone who could kill other roles, that's how we put it, kill other roles, and have challenging roles. So I was so looking forward to it. And when I got a call from Mildred Okwa, and she told me about this job, and I was happy, and I will forever be grateful to Mildred Okwa and Rita Dominic for giving me that chance. So yes, I would say that the meeting was my baby, their baby and my baby, because it brought me out, it moved me from soap to movies. And yeah, the meeting was my first big movie role and big movie gig.
Old enough to be your father. Your father.
You would never, in this your lifetime, get to his age.
For those of you who want to be actresses or actors, and you could learn from this, because I think I picked this on my own and it helped me. When I read my script over and over again, and as I'm reading, I'm picturing how I want to act it, how I would want to say it. And while I'm doing that, while it's still fresh in my mind, I write by the side. I'm a writer, not a writer literally, but I write on my script. So I write by the side the expressions I would love to use when I'm taking this line, and the expressions I would use when the other person is taking their lines, and it helps. Well. So, and I also research, depends on what my character has to do. I have to research. If she has to act crazy, I have to research on how somebody has to act crazy. I think what makes me unique is that I am myself. I'm always myself. Yeah, I learned to be comfortable playing the character, playing the role. I learned to love the character and make me enjoy it. If I'm not enjoying it, the viewers wouldn't. So yeah, I'm always myself. And the sweet little cute Linda Ejiofor. I'm still learning, no, I'm still coming up. But my advice would be read a lot of books. It helps your imagination. It helps build your imagination so that when you're reading scripts, you're imagining how you would play. Watch movies. I watch movies like crazy. I'm a movie person. I would take watching a movie over going out anytime. And go for auditions. It doesn't matter how small it is. You start somewhere, you go for audition, and if they tell you no, don't give up. Go for another one. You don't know where your big break might come from.